Today we're going to install Minecraft Server in a Docker container using Container Station on a QNAP TS-451. I'll show you how to install the Container Station, how to set the share drive to store the Docker images and containers, and how to route the networking for the container. Container Station is a free app from QNAP, available in their App Center. It's similar to the Virtualization Station app in that it can create virtual machines of Linux, but it also supports Dockers. The concept of Dockers is similar to that of a virtual machine, except you aren't virtualizing the entire operating system, you're virtualizing just one application. Because of that, you have a lot less overhead. When you create a container, it holds the information that the application needs to run on the host, and in the QNAP universe, that means it runs on top of the QTS operating system, which itself is based on Linux. In this tutorial, we'll install the Minecraft Server app using a Docker image. There's quite a few packages we can choose from, but I'll use one that requires a minimal amount of configuration and customization. Let's go ahead and log into QTS on the QNAP. The first thing you'll want to do is visit the App Center in order to download and install Container Station. The quickest way to access it is through QTS Essentials. Here, you'll want to look for Container Station and then hit the Install button and select the RAID group in which you want to install it. Now, I have two RAID groups called Data1 and Data2, but I'll install Container Station in the first group where I have all my other apps. This will take some time, so I'll fast forward through this part. Okay, we're back. Let's minimize the App Center, and before I open Container Station, I want to show you how my drives are set up. I'll start QNAP's new Storage and Snapshots Manager, and navigate to the Disk section, where you can see I've got two RAID 1 sets of drives. I've already installed Container Station on RAID Group 1, called Data1, but I'd like to store the actual containers and images on RAID Group 2, called Data2, because those drives have a higher RPM. When I start Container Station for the first time, it'll ask me to create a new auto-populated share folder called Container, and it'll install it by default onto the install drive, which is Data1. To make it store the containers on Data2, I'll simply start the control panel, go to Shared Folders, and create a new folder. Call it Container, and set it to Data2, and hit Create. Let's minimize that and return to Container Station. Let's drop down the box and verify that the container folder is on the correct drive, which it is. If I hadn't manually created the container folder on Data2, it would have created a new shared folder on Data1. Let's hit Start now. It'll take me directly into the dashboard, where you can see I don't have any containers listed in the grid yet. To add one, let's tab over to Create Container. This first screen lists all of the QNAP recommended LXC and Docker packages. They do list one Minecraft package, which I was able to install, but for some reason, it didn't pull the latest version of Minecraft Server. Since my goal is to show you the best out-of-the-box experience, I looked for other Minecraft packages. Let me search for Minecraft, which returns the QNAP recommended package. But if I tab over to the Docker Hub, it'll list all of the available Minecraft packages. I've tried several of these, and I had the best luck with Kitomatics package. Let's click Install and grab the latest version. If you create the container at this point using the default settings, you'll most likely have problems with the network settings of the Minecraft server. Let me show you how I have my virtual switch set up. We'll go over to Control Panel, tap to Network and File Services, and start the network and virtual switch options. Of the two physical adapters, the second one is attached to a virtual switch. I also have two virtual machines going through that switch, one of which is currently active. What I plan to do is make the Minecraft server go through the virtual switch and assign it its own static IP address. Going back to Container Station, let's click on Advanced Settings, where we can set the network mode to Bridge and choose Adapter 2, which is our virtual switch. I'll use static IP and set it to an address that I haven't assigned yet. I'll set mine to .125, Now let's hit Create and wait for the Docker container to be installed. In the meantime, I'll go brew some coffee. Once it's done, you can see the container listed in the Containers section. If I tab over to Overview, you can see that the Minecraft server has actually been started. When you click on the link, it'll show the console output in a window, which shows that the Minecraft world is being created. I'll stop the container for a moment. Let's hop over to FileStation and look at the files that represent the container. I'll click on Container Station Data, then drill down to Lib, then Docker, Volumes, and then this long string that represents the Minecraft server, and finally underscore data. Here you can edit your ops and ban lists, as well as the server properties file. I'll right-click the file to edit it using a text editor, which, by the way, is a free download from the App Center. I always set game mode to creative and difficulty to peaceful for the kids. And save it. Let's go back to Container Station and restart the container. Now, restarting the container actually regenerates the world, so I'll take a quick break while it does that. Okay, the world has been successfully created. Let me quickly go back to the Network and Virtual Switch page to show you how the container fits into the network. As expected, the container is going through the Virtual Switch 1 along with my other virtual machines. At this point, I can switch to my Minecraft client on another PC and hit Multiplayer. I'll direct connect to my server, which is 192.168.1.125. I'll join the server. And we're in. As you can see, the console shows I've logged in. Now I can host a Minecraft server on a very low power QNAP NAS device 24 hours a day. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed.